Good morning, all of you. In environmental education, today we are going to discuss about sustainable land use management. Here we are going to discuss following topics: sustainable land management, that is SLM, second, objectives, attributes, benefits, fifth is relationship between sand quality, land quality, and SLM. First is sustainable land management. SLM is a use of land to meet the changing human needs, that is agriculture, forestry, conservation, while ensuring long-term socio-economic and ecological functions of the land. The objective of SLM is to harmonize the complementary goals of providing environmental, economic, and social opportunities for the benefit of present and future generation, while maintaining and enhancing the quality of land. Here, I am also focusing on an authentic definition given by United Nations. Sustainable land management refers to the use of land resources, including soil, water, animals, and plants, for the production of goods to meet the changing human needs, while simultaneously ensuring the long-term productive potential resources and the maintenance of the environmental functions. Objectives of sustainable land management. First, to combine latest technology, policies, and activities aimed at integrating socio-economic principles with environmental concerns. Second is to maintain and enhance production, that is productivity. Third, to reduce the level of production risk and enhance soil capacity to buffer against degradation processes that can be man-made or natural. This objective is representing the stability and resilience of SLM. Fourth is to protect the potential of natural resources and prevent degradation of soil and water quality, that is representing the protection of SLM. Fifth is to be economically viable. Sixth is to be socially acceptable and assure access to the benefits from improved land management, that is representing the accessibility and equity of SLM. Attributes of sustainable land management. First is, it integrates the technology, policies, and activity with the aim at integration of socio-economic principle for enhancing production, protecting the natural resources, and prevention of soil and water degradation. Second, SLM should be economically viable. Third is, SLM is possible only with social acceptance. Fourth is, SLM requires the integration of biophysical conditions like land quality, soil quality, with the economic and social demands. Fifth is, human habitation has a significant effect on sustainable development and forms the basis of all policies regarding SLM. Benefits of sustainable land management. It is divided into four kinds of services: provisioning services, regulating services, supporting services, or culture services. Provisioning services, that represents increase in food security. It provides energy, local fresh and clean water, and also support livelihoods. Regulating services improve water availability and quality, mitigate damages caused by extreme weather events or natural hazards. It also regulates pests and diseases. Supporting services support nutrient and water settling, along with soil and vegetation cover. It also helps in mitigation of soil degradation and enhance soil quality, structure, and functioning. It also enables nutrient and water settling. It provides habitats for species, which increases our biodiversity. Fourth is culture services. It keeps our culture and natural landscapes alive and protect our cultural heritage. It also enhances aesthetic experiences and provides a space for recreation. Relationship among soil quality, land quality and SLM. Soil quality is the capacity of a specific soil to function within natural or managed ecosystem boundaries to sustain plant and animal production, maintain or enhance water quality and support human health and habitation. Land quality is the condition, state or health of the land relative to human requirements including agriculture production, forestry, conservation and environment management. SLM combines technology, policies and activities aimed at integrating socio-economic principles with environmental concerns so as to simultaneously maintain or enhance production, reduce the level of production risk, protect the potential and natural resources and prevent, that is, buffer against soil and water degradation. Thank you.